Rightio, chest and back day. This is what, our second chest and back day we were recording, so.
I think so.
Should be pretty anabolic. So, if you didn't watch the first one, what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off with bench, then go to incline dumbbell press, then, yeah, low to high cables, then we'll do some pullovers, pull-ups, or muscle-ups for me, and yeah, then some sort of rowing after. We don't know what row we'll do just yet, because on the day we usually decide. Like sometimes we'll use the rowing machine and sometimes we'll put on the bottom cable and use a bottom cable sort of row like what Arnold used to do. And sometimes we'll just do barbell rows. So we don't know exactly what row we'll do, but we'll figure that out when we're at the gym. There is a learner trying to overtake a car and they just aren't speeding up. They're just on the other side of the road, just in line to stop the car.
They're just driving on the other side of the road.
Yeah, I thought they were gonna die. Oh well, no car crashes just yet. But yeah, we'll start with heavy movements and then we'll move to light accessory movements. And that should be a pretty anabolic chest and back day. So we'll see you in the first set.
Oh,
post-workout discussion. So, as you may see, I actually put a shirt back on to hide my canteen lady arms for the way home.
Saggy tits.
Yeah. Let's have a little bit of a breakdown of the workout. So, we started off with bench. I wanted to rep PR, so I put 100 kilos on the bar, or 225 or 222 or whatever the hell it is in pounds. And my previous record was 6, so I wanted to get 7 today. I haven't done 6 in probably a month, but I wanted to get 7 today. Anyway, I got 6, and the 7th one, I pushed it back and it hit the rack. And then I was just pushing it into the rack for a solid 3 seconds before it started coming back down. So I'm blaming it on the rack. If the rack wasn't there, or we had like a half decent bench at my gym, then I would have got 7 reps.
Rule number one, when you fail something, always blame the equipment.
Yeah, exactly. Well, you can watch the video back. You'll see I'm pushing it up and it goes into the rack and it
It was unfortunate.
Yeah. So after I failed that 7th rep, I wanted to do 100 kilos for a little bit more. So I ended up doing it for another, I think, 3 reps after. So I did the first set of 6 and then another 3 on the second set.
Brother, I don't know if it's just this angle or the bulk, but I look wide in this
camera. Well, the wide angle lens ain't on, so I think it's the bulk. But how long have you been bulking? Yeah, how long have you been bulking now? Like 5 months?
like 16 years. No, I've started properly bulking now, probably for like, yeah, 5 months.
Yeah. And you've put on what, 10 kilos or something?
I put on a lot. And
what'd you start at? What weight did you start?
I started at, I want to say like 67, 60, I don't know, mid to high 60s.
Kilos.
Yeah, kilos.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're not going to think pounds, brother.
Yo, like, what's that, like
30 kilos? No, like 25?
It's like 140 pounds. Oh, no, 145 pounds ish.
Started off there. For reference, I am 5'11. No, I'm not. I'm 5'9. And yeah. And now I think I'm hitting at the end of the day around the 77 mark.
So she's putting around 10 kilos in the last 4 months.
And I'm cutting down at the end of the break that we're on now, which is next week. I'm starting my cut, and that's going to go until, what's the 8th month? September.
Yeah.
So that's a month we're in the 4th.
Yeah,
that's a 4-month cut.
So like a 16-week-ish cut, which is plenty to cut down. Obviously, she hasn't gained 10 kilos of lean body tissue.
No, it's been 10 kilos of straight fat and grease.
So we'll see how much she's actually gained muscle wise. She's obviously gained a little bit because she's heap stronger now.
I'm literally gonna look like I've never touched a weight before in my life, and I will commit.
Yeah, well, she's heap stronger now, so yeah. She should have put on muscle. But yeah. Then again, mass moves mass, so she might
I'll
just be fat.
Stop. But yeah.
No, we'll document a bit of that on this.
Yeah.
And yeah, she's trying to get lean for her school formal.
School formal, gotta look good, gotta have the back out. What are you? He's on an in-between thing right now?
Yeah, I'm trying to do what Greg Doucette says in our main gain. So I'm like, I'm doing it because I can't be tossed to bulk because there's so much effort to eat that much food. So I'm eating like my maintenance a little bit higher than my maintenance and gaining weight. I'm like, I think I'm 85 and a half in the morning now, kilos, which is like 190 pounds. And and at night I'm like 87. So yeah, I'm like almost 200 pounds. I'm like 194, 195 pounds at night. So I'm trying to get up to 200, but you know, still having half visible abs. I do boxing, which helps for a lot of the cardio. Like, I'm a bit of a Sam Sulek advocate in the way of cardio. You should be doing cardio. I think it helps you maintain a good physique. She doesn't do cardio, but when,
you can tell from my jawline in this fucking camera, bro.
When the, No, when the cut comes, she's gonna have to do cardio.
I'll do cardio when the cut's happening.
So she's got another week of no cardio, then she has to, you know, actually train her heart. But yeah, no, it should be interesting. So yeah, as we were saying, we did bench, then we moved to incline dumbbell press. I was weak as piss at that, but I'm blaming that after doing the so many reps of 100 kilos on bench. Then we moved to the low to high cables, as you would have seen. That felt pretty good. I've got like a little bit of a pinch in my shoulder, which sort of didn't feel great, but I wasn't gonna bitch out.
My left shoulder's just crunchy as fuck.
It was my right shoulder today that was a bit haunt.
Our family's not good with shoulders.
No, we got pretty average genetics in the way of joints.
Yeah.
Knees and shoulders are not great.
Not the best. And then we did
We did the pullovers, the cable pullovers. I did pull-ups. She did the single arm pull-down machine. And then did the bottom cable rows, which all felt pretty good. And we got a pretty decent pump. But yeah, it was just a pretty fun session overall. It wasn't super duper hard. We trained to failure on like the heavy ones, but we didn't really go to failure too much on the lighter accessory movements. I didn't. She probably did. It was just because I got boxing and I didn't want to be a complete jellyfish there. So, you know, didn't train to complete failure. Yeah, anyway, it was pretty good. We did everything that we wanted to do. So we'll probably see you on Wednesday in Lakes.
Yeah.
So we'll see you then.